wrong with it?
I can't fuck with that, bro. That is not something
fucking
I'm
weird.
What's wrong with
something wrong with this mental.
I just want to know what's wrong with it.
Apparently, this episode is of the Crips.
I mean, I ain't gonna lie.
The Crips and the Track Star Dads, because that's what you and Shaw look like.
So, buenos noches.
Hey, you going to hell.
I'm not pissed.
Go to hell.
Why are you doing it?
Because that shit look fun.
No, they all had hoes in them.
All of them had something for fun.
They was all booty hoes. Yeah, Miley was trying to send this subliminal
shit. Hey, have you ever did that before?
Talking to her.
You ever fisting?
No. Thank you.
No, you did.
It wasn't a fist, but it was a knuckle check.
It was a knuckle check.
And I was like, if I just push through, nigga, what's gonna happen?
That's tough, though. That's hard.
That shit was hard.
That shit was nice.
No.
No.
I'm scared. I'm about to bust this shit.
Y'all fat as hell, by the way.
Fat?
The fact that she had to put some.
No, we saved it on you. We make sure it's on the side. Now you're trying to make our backs wide and shit for nothing.
Yeah.
Only wide back
we
out is Mike.
You.
This time.
Even though you were
girl, fuck you.
Thank you.
Can I get one of those, please?
Oh,
I didn't even know we had some. As soon as I got here, I was looking for some water.
You might as well bring it. No,
I'm sharing this shit, man. I'm sharing this
double
shit.
Dub.
Okay, I was just waiting for you to share that motherfucker.
I don't share shit.
Let it intro. Are you sharing? Yeah, intro. Hold on. We'll be right back.
Bro, you're not gonna change my politics about how I do this shit.
You're damn right, I'm gonna change your politics about how you do this
not.
Shit.
Nigga,
they know what you do, we know what you do. They know you lick coochie.
So
be a coochie licker, all right?
This ain't about coochie
licker, bro.
You trying to make it about coochie like that was the whole conversation.
Don't be that, my nigga. Listen, I watched Grey's Anatomy today.
What the fuck does this have to do with anything?
It taught me that you need to be gay and proud. Don't be gay and closeted, my nigga.
Who is gay and closeted?
Don't be that person. You can be better.
Only person I know, two gay closeted people. That's Mike and Shy.
Hold on. Don't be freaky and confused, man.
What? Be freaky and freaky.
I'm not. What are y'all talking about?
Like, are you a boy that dresses like a girl that dresses like a stud?
We are one and the same, Mike.
I'm a you're right. You're American made man.
You're funny as fuck.
The way he worded that shit was clever.
Yeah, like you're funny for that, bro. I ain't even gonna lie.
Hey, man, welcome back to Popular Ignorance, man. I'm your humble, gracious host, man, Angelo Corleone. Ooh, to my right, man, we got Big Nate back in the building. Behind her, we got Lonnie Bands. To her left, man, Shoddy. Back in the building.
What a camera
hey,
look.
What's the word, nigga? How you living?
Shit.
You look like Super Crit today.
Mm-hmm. Oh, girl, you know.
And da-da-da-da.
You know. That nigga super fixed.
This for my people in the DR. I didn't get the flag, but I got this.
Oh, respect. Mm-hmm. And beside him is the biggest blood in the world. Big Money D-Lo. What's up?
Yo.
How y'all living, nigga? We got a good show plan for these niggas.
Mike look like he fixed tires.
But before we get
I look like I fixed tires.
That's crazy.
Shit, I could.
I super fixed hers.
But nah, man, how was y'all week? Talk to me. What's going on? How's your Valentine's Day?
Fuck Valentine's.
Yeah. Fuck Valentine's Day.
I
was so caught up with the shit from the parade, I forgot about Valentine's Day.
Before we even get into Valentine's Day, moment of silence for the parade real quick. Alright, man, back to the bullshit. Valentine's Day.
I had a great Valentine's Day.
Yeah, I had a good time. I saved all my money that day.
I chilled.
Yeah.
I didn't remember what I did. I saved over $100 by switching to Geico.
Shut the fuck up, yo. Lonnie, why was your Valentine's Day so good?
You know, self-love is the best love.
Get the fuck out. Don't do that. I know
what you was in the house doing.
You was playing DJ Hero?
Yeah.
No, I was just having self-love. A good time. I was just having
time. I bet.
You got some flowers?
I did get some flowers.
I got a lot
of flowers on Valentine's Day.
That's it. That's specific.
You talking about weed roses? What we talking about?
Oh, no. Y'all, I don't have one of those. I've never got one of those.
We're not talking about one of those.
Oh, what you talking about?
Freak ass girl.
Oh, no, I got some roses.
Nasty girl.
You a freak. You need to be stopped.
Nasty.
Gosh, I thought we were talking about that. No, I got some roses.
I thought we was talking about that.
She was definitely doing something freaky on Valentine's Day. But the flowers.
Roses, are those your favorite flowers?
No, my favorite flower is lilies.
Lilies?
I love lilies.
What kind? There's all different types of lilies.
Lily liquors?
I just like lilies, all lilies.
You
all
lit.
Ain't there some white and yellow ones?
No, they can be pink, purple, yellow.
I definitely got a woman some pink flowers.
They on my shelf.
I love a good orchid.
I like what orchids, the fuck? Too. Those are beautiful.
Who cares what you want?
That's fucked up.
That's true, Tati.
On the show. You gotta chill.
Now that you took down your sewing braids, it's only one woman on the show.
I mean, call it what you want. Hey.
Your sewing braids.
Sheesh.
You're still a boy.
Back.
You like Pinocchio. I'm calling you Pinocchio for now because you want to be a
You gotta tune her up for that, bro.
I love it here. I love how y'all love to hate.
Who is y'all?
The haters. We already established who y'all is. Every time I say y'all, it's to hate. My shit ain't hate.
It's the purest form of love.
I'm trying to teach you how to be a real man.
You can never teach me how to be a real man.
Chin up, chest out, man.
It's okay, Pinocchio.
I don't know what y'all on. Y'all just love to hate.
Anywho, man, hey. Tell you who did have a good fucking Valentine's Day?
You did.
No, I had a great Valentine's Day, man. I took my face off and smashed, you know.
What?
Like that. What? I was tongue deep in ass. For sure, for sure. What are you talking about?
Type shit.
Oh, God.
These are proud ass eaters.
No, that's a fact for sure. But I'm saying, like, never mind. I ain't trying to get into no deeds, bro.
What you want? I was definitely, like, almost teeth deep in that motherfucker. You know what I mean?
Teeth deep.
Have you ever put your lip over the teeth, my nigga? And so you don't crack no skin or nothing. I'm respectful like that to my bitch. You know what I mean?
Dislocated his jaw.
What? I'm respectful like that to what? That's my bitch. I love her. I'm gonna do that, of course. What do you mean?
Did you buy her flowers?
Nah, I licked her ass. I provided dick on Valentine's Day.
Is that not what y'all provide?
I mean, hey.
Cheeks.
So which would you rather want on Valentine's Day?
Please give me flowers.
Fuck out of here.
What you giving your man?
Exactly. Nothing.
That's not true.
What do you mean it depends?
It shouldn't depend. It don't depend on who your woman is.
I like romance, so I'm a hopeless romantic. Mm-hmm. I'd buy my man flowers, a card, and
don't buy no nigga flowers.
Respect.
Wow, I know men that like flowers.
On Valentine's Day.
Nah, flowers is cool, but a card is brazy.
Yo, I love this card.
I'd take the card over the flowers.
A piece of paper.
She probably spilled her heart on that motherfucker.
Yeah.
That bitch went and got them up from the Hallmark towel.
Listen, I'm not gonna hold you. I got hot status for my gift.
So, on some real,
I get you something.
I swear to God.
If I go on my way to get you some
exotic massage
and perfume and all that good shit, like, you smell good.
I'm from Wisconsin.
You better come correct. I'm gonna say
this right now. I'm the first nigga.
We celebrate Sweetest Day.
If a woman asks me, y'all should be proud of me. Look at me. Growth. I didn't call y'all the B word.
Growth.
But look, if a woman was to ask me like what I wanted or something, I'm gonna tell her like shit, it don't matter. But woman, if you know me and then paid attention to me, you better do some.
That's what I'm saying. You gotta pay attention to know the
gifts. Cause you're gonna be all type of B words when you come with some broke ass shit. Like some, don't come
what's
with
the
me.
Shit I just don't like.
What if I don't like this shit at all?
Like, yeah, like,
I don't like
have you been?
But that's why they gotta know you. They gotta know you.
Give me some shit I don't like. I'm just gonna feel like you was trying to be funny. Like you was being funny.
But
like,
what if she genuinely got the goodness of her heart? Like, you know, what if she gets a bad gift giver?
Some of them
she's
are
a stupid. Dumb. She's a dumb. Never mind.
Don't say the word. Be nice.
She's a dumb woman.
There you go.
Because that lead into my question. So like, realistically, and y'all, for our viewers, please feel free to chime in on this as well. But for the females, the women, really, what do you get a man for Valentine's Day? Because me personally,
you
gotta know him, yeah.
So like when I was dating my dude that I dated,
it's different buying a gift for another man, bro.
Right. Gay love is always different. Huh? Alright, I'm done. That's my last one. I'm out of here. I'm out of here. Go ahead.
Okay, yeah, I'm done.
What's your point? I'm sorry. I'm done. That's my last one.
You got it. Go ahead.
No, but like they say, it just depends. Like you know, I make my dude like a basket of everything that I know. Like
that he likes, right?
Respect.
Yeah.
You know, we kind of split the big bag.
And if your dude don't even like gifts, he like experiences, then you could take your man out on the town, just show him a good time. It just really depends on your dude, like for sure.
And it depends on your girl.
Yeah.
Or woman, my bad. Yeah. I don't want to disrespect
look at you.
I don't like gifts. Like getting gifts make me uncomfortable. Mm. But if you want to go try something, do something different.
I like that.
Go to fucking aquarium, let's go.
All right, so I got another question to piggyback off of that. I got one more question to piggyback off of that. So are men even supposed to get gifts for Valentine's Day? Because I don't never really see too much of that.
Yeah, it just depends on the girl that you date.
I definitely feel like it's an equal, definitely a give and take. However, like where I'm from, they don't do men Valentine's Day gifts because they celebrate Sweetest Day in October.
Sweetest Day?
Yeah, so like on October 17th, all the stores fill up with like Valentine's Day stuff. And it's for the men. Like, that's when the women go all out for the men where I'm from.
And where is that?
Milwaukee.
Okay. That's fly. Yeah. That's fly as fuck.
Well, I thought she was about to say Minnesota or some shit like that.
I thought she was going to say
Minnesota would have been crazy.
That's fly for real, because it's like.
What we hunting? New PS5?
Valentine's Day is typically, you would think it's like portrayed as like a day for women. You do what I'm saying?
But so Valentine like, was a male and he was.
But I feel like it's only like that because the only thing
it's been commercialized to make money by industry. That's what Valentine's Day has been, because Saint Valentine is a man. It's nothing about. It wasn't the Valentine's Day. The whole shit, Cupid, all that shit. That's industry shit. That shit that's been put out so they can make a day, so they can make money off this day. At the end of the day, everything going on sale. You got rings, cameras. You got fucking. Everything possible that a motherfucker would want on Valentine's Day. It's just another way to make money. It's a paganism holiday. No, it's crazy.
I feel like,
oh gosh, you got
it's for me.
Hit you with the science on that shit. Nigga. I'm playing with niggas. What you mean? She was
so get off the scientific pontification of that situation. You feel me?
I mean,
you know, I feel like it's just a day where, you know, females really feel like it's their day. Because don't no man really care about Valentine's Day.
But then
Day.
That's the Are case. We? What's Mother's Day? Hmm? If that's the day for females.
But don't know. But you don't see dudes turning up for.
When we just talking about
niggas can't turn up for Father's Day. Like, oh, it's Father's Day. Like, you don't see niggas like.
Because these bitches daddy's gone.
Whoa.
And bitches want to be daddy so goddamn bad.
It depends on your
but I'm
it
saying,
depends
like,
on the culture.
But I'm saying, like, this is my thing. With females, everything, the day for a female is always the most important day.
That's so weird, because I don't even feel like, I don't celebrate holidays, but I don't feel like Valentine's Day is strictly for the woman. Because even though I don't celebrate Valentine's Day, I never strip my son of, you know, his stuff. So, like, still get him stuff, get my mom stuff. Like, I thought Valentine's Day was just about showing love and appreciation to everybody in the circle that you love and appreciate.
I'm sorry, I think
I'm
message
though.
Yeah. Ahead, come on. They said something about Father's Day, right? For example, my child's mother, right? Mm-hmm. Her pop passed, so that's the day she grieved on, you feel me? So you don't really get that day either.
Yeah, that's different.
You feel me?
Real shit. That's different. Shit. Y'all see that shit with, what's that nigga's name? In Hibachi 54, what's the 54 Hibachi nigga?
Boss Man D-Lo.
Boss Man D-Lo.
Hey, man, so look, all right, that's one nigga had a bad Valentine's Day, and then we gonna go over to Freddie Gibbs.
That motherfucker was. Well, she don't
Spready Gibbs is crazy, I know. But I can't play it. Listen, I can't play the video itself, but I play a little bit of the audio. Rick Ross' baby mama need to be stopped. Her and her teeth.
No, she don't.
Her and her teeth got to get out of here, bro.
Nah, stop this bitch. She doing what she doing.
This bitch is a demon.
I love her.
She a demon.
Myla, your text just came through 1 minute ago. You sleep funny. Look at you. Stop playing, bro. Go to bed, dog. Because I wouldn't have been good. I could go where the fuck I want to go because I am a licensed Florida realtor. All my family law enforcement.
If you was a church, I would tell
and
you.
I don't give a fuck. I slap one of they motherfucking ass in the mouth too and go to the jailhouse like this. Bitch, I don't give a fuck about what you talking about, where I can't come from. You talking about robbing me? Rob me, bitch. Take what? Rob whose son? Which one you talking about? Because if you talking about that baby boy, his daddy coming at you, nah, ho, I just told him. I just gave him the green light. You got us fucked up down here in Dade County, bitch. Come back to Design District. This is my city.
Like I said, this is Rick Ross, baby.
Go to Bell Harbor if you got your big budget. That's your dumb ass done signed to Alamo or whoever the fuck I heard. You signed too early. Now you mad because I popped you up. And now you want to re-orchestrate your deal and get you a bag? Bitch, that's you. Read, fuck boys. Write shit down. Maybe your mom ain't teaching shit. I keep shit around here. You want a book or two? Fine. Go read Dr. Spencer, Who Moved My Cheese First. I don't know what jailhouse you talking about. You from the streets, nigga. You say you went to you did prison time. You a real street nigga. I read all your text messages to the world. Just DM me again the other day because I reposted something somebody sent me and said, you need to pay this lady. You DM me and even tap back with your ass.
All right, whole point is this. That's crazy. You over eat the Popeye's biscuit with no drink. But
no, that's a church's boy.
I don't know how you living, boy.
No, when I was pregnant,
oh, shut on.
I ate 10 of those biscuits in one sitting. I haven't been able to touch them.
Are we filming something for Valentine's
Day?
We gotta play her video.
Oh, should we put some of that nigga getting his ass exposed and shit like that?
The hibachi?
The hibachi.
Not yet.
Okay.
What?
Wait.
Oh, it's Freddie. Oh, hold on. Freddie Gibbs, too. Hold on.
Wait. Let me play my video. Which one is it?
Hibachi.
Which one is my video?
I'm not sure, nigga.
One?
What's your question? Hold on. What's your question?
I got three demons on here. I got three well-known demons.
Ask the question, bro.
Three well-known demons. So is manwich excluded and now is hibachi?
Hibachi on God. I'm calling this shit hibachi for now.
Bro, I don't call it.
Yeah,
nothing,
I never called it none of that.
I called it manwich first.
That shit's funny.
I didn't call it none of that, bro.
Call it what it is. Get your ass a. That's a nigga.
Listen, so you call me hibachi.
What are we talking about?
So this demon calling it hibachi.
Y'all change something. I hate it here.
Y'all calling it sex.
Y'all calling it sex.
The Brodies. Y'all calling it sex.
I'm not calling it nothing.
Yeah. No, because I heard.
You said some wild shit, boy. I've been watching this podcast for a while. Here, take this, Miss
Lake.
And come on.
What I think is, bro, like.
No, because you cuss up, bro.
What I say. He do, but.
You said.
What?
Yeah.
What? Yeah.
I had one of them, but nah.
I ain't trying to even
go back.
Go back to that.
But you just call it sex, right?
Yeah.
That's your sex.
Yeah.
You just call it.
That is some exclusive sex.
When I grow it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I get it. I understand
what type shit.
It ain't hibachi.
Nah, it ain't hibachi.
Hibachi.
It ain't hibachi. I don't know what y'all talking about.
It's crazy. I'm not going to call it
hibachi.
That's nasty, bro. I'm not going to call it nasty, bro. But nah, the only reason I bring it up is because, like I said, that nigga, Boss Man D-Lo got exposed, and this nigga, Freddie Gibbs, got exposed. Freddie Gibbs posted a picture with his new wife. The only reason I bring this up happened during Valentine's Day. It was revenge porn relating to that subject. So Valentine's Day, Freddie Gibbs got posted a picture of him and his new baby mama and shit like that. His ex posted a picture of him spreading his ass wide open.
He was spreading it.
Spreading wide open, bro. I'm not gonna hold it. All over Twitter's timeline. He was spreading his ass open. This nigga basically was like, bitch, fuck you. And some more shit.
Wait a minute.
Like, fuck you. That's all I can say back. Like, fuck you. Get some money, bitch. Like, for real. Like,
he was spreading his cheeks.
But hold on. He was fucking with a porn star to get some, like, some backline.
It doesn't make it better. You don't let nobody take a picture of you spreading.
Now, he's spreading open porn and sent the
picture.
He sent the picture.
That's how you know that was too freaky. Y'all didn't see how she said it.
Hold on, boy.
That's some freaky shit because how she had to say that.
Her ass is, bro.
She said spreading. Like, boy, yeah, like
what you say?
If he took a picture,
oh God, you do it. He said spreading them. Oh God.
That nigga propped his phone up, set a timer.
Yep. And nigga just
Wait, he took the picture?
Oh, he out of She didn't take the picture. He took the picture and sent it to her.
Hold on, wait.
Like I said, to get more context, she said like a while. That's crazy.
You just did that on live as a grown man. Exactly.
As a grown man.
Yeah, fuck this nigga.
So a nigga asked for that picture. I don't know no bitch telling a nigga to send me your asshole. On my mama, I swear to God, I'll block a bitch.
I ain't never heard none of my freakiest friends say I didn't ask that nigga for a picture.
Hey, but she a porn star though.
I never said it.
Let me
tell you. But would you? How would you feel if a bitch asked you for a picture of your booty?
I'm gonna tell her to go get her people. Cause I'm about to beat them the fuck up.
Exactly. It's not even something that.
But don't put that shit past no female though, bro. Bitches be
talking about
it. Yeah, just so they could post it.
Because
that was out of pocket. That don't turn me on. Maybe in the room.
Lonnie, I don't believe you.
Fuck up. Y'all didn't let me finish. I said maybe in the room, but sending me a picture? That's
maybe in the room.
Maybe in the room is crazy.
Huh? That'll throw me off. I'm sorry. I don't want to open my phone and see.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I don't want to see that.
Y'all want to do y'all list?
Y'all keep going past. Hold on, let Nate do her video after we got this,
and then we'll go to that.
I'm tired of you, big back motherfuckers.
My bad. All right, so I got back in here.
How do you know you love me?
I don't.
Yes, I do.
No, but like you really don't, and you know I'm like the type of person. I'm always going to tell you the truth, no matter what.
Right.
And you don't want the answer to that.
I want the honest, truthful answer.
No, I promise you, like, if I tell you the answer, you might break up.
I want the answer.
I'm breaking up for sure.
You sure? My love, you sure? Like, I'm really giving you the chance to back out of this. Are you sure? 100% positive. This is
true. I'm 100% sure I want the answer.
Pussy is trash. And I didn't care. That's how I knew I really was in love with you.
Is that true?
Oh my goodness, no.
He said her pussy was trash.
But that's why he stuck around. That's how he knew he loved her.
Nah.
Why are you making that face?
Like that, I love you for everything else, you feel me? Like, I'm just not here for sex, you feel me? Genuine love, but that's how I knew.
I love y'all. Where y'all going?
I would have turned the camera off.
She's still recording. Okay.
Strong back bitch. That's what she was.
What's up? I mean,
that's basically what he said.
But hold on, that's probably immaculate though.
That's not enough to kiss.
Y'all
ain't
liking
it.
For everything else that you do, but your pussy.
So my question is, if a bitch doing everything
that y'all need a bitch to do, but that ass is trash, y'all sticking around?
Yeah.
No. Yeah.
That's exactly what he said.
Yeah.
Facts. Because that's what you all need a bitch to do.
I mean, oh, see?
You're right. I ain't gonna lie. I'm going to.
You got to. You should be a strong. It should be allowed. Like,
damn, we should be allowed.
Yeah, she don't know. She just found out.
If your coochie trash, you should already place it, man. That's like if your dick little. Your bitch not. Like, come on, man. Your bitch gonna be
And you're gonna get cheated on.
You hear me?
Gonna be fucking. Your bitch gonna be fucking, man. It's inevitable. But you know if your pussy trash, you might as well just go out here and just go on out here and fuck your best.
What makes a pussy trash?
Fuck some of your cousins, some of your aunties. Matter of fact, get on Tinder, swipe left for me a couple times. Do something adjustable. You know what I mean?
Friends, I think you just leave it at the friends.
Leave it at the friends?
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie.
You shouldn't grip into her family.
You know that motherfucker suck. You hear me?
He did. Who wait?
Females.
You tell females. females when you having sex with them that is trash? If it's trash,
no, I don't tell them that. Not all of them.
I ain't gonna lie. You gonna know your shit. You gonna know your shit.
I done dealt with some crazy women in my life. I'm cool. I can't just be out here talking to
people. I ain't gonna tell you your shit trash, but you gonna know your shit wasn't that when I don't spin back.
No, I'm not. That nigga Sterling said if she's resourceful, so he gonna stick with that trash.
So
ass.
You gonna hey, hear me back
now, Sterling?
If it hey. Was good.
But the thing is,
so that well, the opposite thing is if a well, nah, cause you niggas,
the bitches, the
niggas gonna make it.
I don't know. I ain't gonna even ask.
Nah, cause we know a bitch is staying around and that shit won't be it. Won't no, nothing I'm be good
if
for her.
The sex good as fuck, but she ain't.
Damn, see, y'all done got me in my bag again, boy.
If the sex good as fuck, but she ain't doing shit that can contribute to your
fake
life,
nothing you know is crazy.
No,
on her back.
That is disgusting.
You said what?
He said spit on the back.
Spit on the back.
I ain't gonna lie. I really do want to spit on a woman's face.
What?
Can y'all put this nigga the fuck out?
I told you.
I told you.
Now,
I do that too.
Put him out.
I would really just like want to be awesome.
I'm going outside.
Yeah. I'm just saying. Like,
what the fuck is she talking about? I'm slippery.
That's crazy.
Whoa, Tati.
I don't think she meant to put slippery.
No, she did.
That was grown. What was going on where you were slippery?
Wait, 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 wait.
I think you said, whoa.
She said, if it's not right good, now? I'm not staying.
My brother.
That's what
slippery.
She said.
Oh, so you're slippery, like you going to get up out of there?
She going to get up out of there.
Or is you slippery right now? Like, I'm trying to,
yeah,
I'm
D-Lo.
Trying to get some clarity.
Yeah.
Y'all freaky frogs.
D-Lo look like he going to take you. give me the crack.
I ain't taking nothing.
No, I'm talking with the mask.
Oh.
It's just giving. Put the pussy in the bag.
That nigga Sterling. Wow.
I ain't taking nothing. Huh?
Y'all in the comments wilding today.
Yeah, y'all freaky.
Freaking the motherfucker in the comments.
Yes, sir. Crip cake. You know. Yes, sir.
Fuck that suck ass shit.
Hey, the way he threw up his seat is kind of sick.
Boy. It's kind
of. Yeah, his seat was a little. About, it was a little nigga. Special ed. Don't do it.
It's like the dude off Fat Albert.
No. Don't do that.
Do
but
some dusty ass
your shit. Your shit was cocked in.
Oh, she said.
She said quick.
That nigga was cocked in.
Quick. Yeah.
That's what you mean.
That's what she meant.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Shit, what you want me to?
No, your seat was cocked in hard. Like, you were like to fight a bitch.
How she said slippery means I have a new man. I found a new man.
You didn't hear her just say that?
No, he was trying to have biscuits.
Slippery means slip on out my
ear. Yeah, I'm going to melt in your mouth, huh?
Whoa.
You can't say stuff like that.
Dog. You bitch said some odd shit.
That need to be a voice time.
Can't
say stuff like that.
You
said, hey, podcast boyfriend
to change. Podcast boyfriend, switch the fuck up. Switch the fuck up real quick.
She came on this motherfucker. She
That's
came
Mrs.
on this motherfucker.
Now.
Oh, wow.
No.
Mrs. Peel.
It's Mrs. Crazy. Peel is crazy.
She ain't the same no more. She done came out of shell and everything. She talking and shit now.
Mrs. Peel Crip.
Mrs. Phil Britt.
Blue Pill Creep is crazy.
Blue Pill Creep.
That's my name.
It don't
don't
get
wear
no
it out.
Good than that, bro.
She wearing blue and shit.
Oh, God. She came up here big creepy.
Dressed up and shit.
Yeah, we're talking about All-Star Weekend. What y'all doing, man?
Man, what y'all wearing? What, boy?
All this shit.
I hope y'all girls wasn't at All-Star Weekend.
Oh, friend, I
like that. Hey, the dunk contest
baby.
Wasn't the only thing that sucked. You hear me?
Damn.
Shit.
Why you want that?
Y'all, so I sent in a video this week, but it has nothing to do with what we was talking about, y'all. It is literally just a funny, but it's not funny. Like, but you might laugh, but it's not
it's
funny.
It's not funny.
It's okay. Like, we're going to talk about it.
Just warn us how much it suck already.
No, just, it's not funny, though.
All right, let's see what happens.
We're
going to
see. We're
going to
see.
Because now you got my curiosity before we talk about
all
let's see what the fuck going on.
I'm intrigued. I'll be going back.
Where he was going?
That's fucked up.
No, y'all, I'm only laughing because of the caption that they had for it.
Who was it?
It was when you see who's daddy's favorite for real.
I was about to say that, bro. You can tell who the favorite is.
No, y'all.
That's a side baby for sure.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie.
Hey,
but that's the shit right there. That's why little Conrad about to he gonna grow up and he gonna blow that. Fuck school.
No, y'all.
Fuck
after watching that video a lot of times, y'all know I'm a stalker.
Leave me off, Dad.
Y'all know like I'm a stalker. I watched it a couple times. I do not think that man's intention was to let that baby fall. You know how kids just be doing stuff, and he just jumped too quick. But the other baby probably fell. That's why he turned and looked.
Fuck, now
he
looked at the baby.
Y'all, dead. No, he did not let that baby fall. I would not want to believe that that grown man did that. That was his girlfriend's child. Don't start no stuff.
Oh God, I dare you.
You would have did that?
I didn't know the little nigga was gonna jump.
Listen, if it's one of the little badass kids that don't like it, ain't mine. With silver teeth? What? With silver teeth? Hey, little fucker, you better land on your feet.
With silver teeth?
What?
Bro.
Oh, he fucked up.
One of my coworkers.
Y'all are horrible.
One of my coworkers got a son with a silver cap, bro. I swear to God, every time I see that little boy, I be like, boy, you's a bad little motherfucker, bro.
I hate badass little kids. I'm ready to fuck them up. I swear to God, man.
And then I hate the women who allow that shit. Like, they don't say nothing. They don't do it. They just let them.
No, you.
Remember Shorty House, we was over, her little son used to walk up, wow, punch
the
shit out.
Bro, the little nigga came in and bit me in my knee. I tell his mom, like, bro, I'm your like son. It. I'm like, your son just bit me in my knee. She gonna tell me, boy, fuck your knee. I'm like,
boy, yeah, fuck your son. Kids.
Yeah, like, boy, when I knee this little nigga, then what?
I'm mad.
No, I wouldn't need you. I ain't gonna hold you. I feel like,
I hate when I'm telling this my is why. Son that's why. To back up off somebody, and they tell me, like, oh, no, he cool. Because, like, I know my son. He's still learning. He's still learning boundaries. He's still learning, like, you know, to give people their space and stuff. So when I tell them, like, I'm not saying, like, oh, my son can't be on you because I don't trust you and stuff. Like, I'm saying, like, I'm making him give you space. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. People be like, oh, no, he fine. He a kid. I understand. I'm like, shut the fuck up. I said what I said.
You don't know where this is about to go. Be quiet.
Yeah, like, I know my son. He'll get to beating on somebody quick. Right. I turn my head, you know? So.
My daughter got this biting shit bad. I ain't gonna lie to you, boy. She bit the shit out of my shoulder the other day. Hey, little helper. Hey, I damn near threw it through a goddamn wall. I had to remember who she was for like 2 seconds.
And they teeth are sharp.
Boy, what?
When they young. Sharp. Like, sharp. Yeah.
And she only got 5 of them motherfuckers. I don't know what the fuck going on, man. It's strong. Them motherfuckers. Yeah. All that milk she drink. Good calcium. Shit. Man, fuck kids, man. I love y'all, but fucking kids.
Yeah.
That is
crazy. Definitely fuck kids.
I second that notion. No.
So I got his CDLs and stepdaddy.
Yeah, he do got his CDLs though.
Like, he got his class A, B, and C.
Class, all that.
Oh, yeah.
I'm the truck driver.
No, that nigga got his SDL.
Yeah, that's what we meant.
He got a stepdaddy license.
Yeah,
I definitely have that.
Certified stepdaddy.
Yeah, I definitely have that. I ain't got that no more. I actually expired, to be honest, because I ain't nobody else getting that out of me on the beat.
You say
I don't believe you, Shy.
He's lying.
How come?
I don't believe it. It never expires.
You don't renew that motherfucker on the low.
It never expires.
Shy, you lying.
Hold on. So you ain't saying nothing?
You podding right now.
I think you're going to renew
Kiara
that motherfucker.
Said her son bit that? Her one time. She bit him back.
You love him.
Yeah, my daughter bit me. She know not to bite. If she bit me, I bit her back. She pulled my hair. I pulled her hair back.
That nigga said SDL a real thing.
Yeah, stepdaddy likes this is a real thing, you feel me? Type shit.
Yeah. You know,
that's why I stopped working at daycare. The kid square up with you. Hey, listen. Kid got one time to square up. We're going to kick that little fucker in the face.
Little fucker.
But I don't like kids enough to even play with kids, especially, like, bro.
Somebody else's kids?
Hey, ghetto ass little boys, bro. Like, bro, why are you
hey, what already thugging at Cat Williams?
You already thugging at 5.
What you gonna do if one of them little kids Cat Williams your ass? And him your stupid ass up.
Have that
you
is
I swear to God, I wish.
I feel like he was unprepared.
So,
I feel like he was unprepared.
He have his feet right.
Oh, God.
He was gonna be happy to see him. No.
Oh, God.
But I'd have been giving niggas wet willies and shit.
That's my childhood hero in the goddamn basketball court, bro. Somebody probably really looked up to Cat Williams. Probably really love that nigga.
This little broke nigga.
So was he ever fighting back in the video?
I don't think he got a chance.
I don't think he tried. That was a kid.
He tried, but shit.
He tried, but
you tried.
Know, put him in a judo hold.
It was unsuccessful.
Then what you gonna do?
That is horrible.
Hey, just imagine being a grown man getting did the worst way by a 12-year-old.
He was like 14, bro.
He 36.
Boy, you better not talk shit about nobody.
I'm not gonna say what I was about to say. Never mind.
I ain't gonna lie. My nigga Hank done got beat up by my little brother. My little brother got beat bro the fuck up.
Bro, he podding, bro. You got beat up by a little. Who beat me? Who beat you up?
My little brother, nigga. My little brother.
You can. Shy wouldn't tell y'all that. Shy wouldn't even lie like that.
He did. He said it on.
Nah, little Shy wouldn't lie like that.
Little Shy wouldn't lie like that.
On God. That's crazy.
Your brother name.
You bro. Probably got. You God. Probably got beat up by the little nigga. That I would
nigga
believe.
Never, boy.
The little nigga already damn. Your height.
He is my hype, but that don't mean he could beat my ass. Boy, he need
Dev got beat up by his little bro.
Damn, they was in the comments saying it.
What?
Damn, bro.
Then we got beat up by Lil Rocky.
Damn, bro.
I hate trolling ass niggas, man.
Let them know Sean came over there and did bro dirty.
I will call that little nigga right now.
Call.
And if he vouch for you, I'm beating all y'all ass call right
him
now.
Call him.
We on the pod, but we gotta get back to this all-star shit. But call that nigga real quick.
Let's see, call that nigga.
I need to see if he really beat your ass.
He might got school in the morning.
He might, now he's still in school.
Oh, yeah.
He's still in school?
He's a junior.
Beloved.
Come on, man. I'm sorry, Mama Cookie, but you knew I would have beat your son ass that day, right? Like,
shit, boy.
Damn. And I still get to ask him my fucking revenge porn question.
Boy, me and Obel would have did you so bad, boy.
Y'all'd have had to. That'd have been the only way Shy had got off.
I would have gave him a scandalous knee to the head, boy. And I would have hit his show.
Hey, I thought you was calling him. What happened?
Oh, God.
He's scared.
Y'all said after the show.
Get
no,
married.
Call a nigga right
no,
now.
Call him on
before
the
phone. Don't
call the little nigga.
What we do all
and
star
don't,
weekend?
Don't get on our head, nigga.
Matter of fact. Bro, I ain't about to. I don't know why I'm doing all this with y'all niggas, bro. I ain't got beat up by nobody in life, boy.
Okay, because we don't take L's, twin.
You hear me?
Come on.
What the fuck they talking about?
I need to
that
know.
That nigga got beat up by all them zoos and wham whams. He was eating in high school.
All I know is shit. You better not go out of town. That little nigga need a ride if he lie like this. He better not call me.
Hey, Sean.
He better not call me.
Hey, Sean. I got you on the pod right now, right?
Yeah.
Hey, so didn't you beat Mike ass that one day?
What one day? Be specific. What day?
Didn't you beat him up?
What about it, man, buddy?
Yeah. Didn't you do him dirty? Say it again. Say it louder.
Hey!
Yeah!
He said
he's
your ass.
He better not ever call me. Don't ever disrespect my little brother like that. Now
you about to get that little nigga a noogie. On God, I'm about to get his little ass a wedgie or something next time I see him.
Hey.
Wait, what?
You got to look,
bro. Mike can't fuck him.
Giving a grown man a wedgie is sick. Cause what if you miss his draws? Then you just a handful of ass. You ever thought about that? Bet you won't give him a wedgie now.
I'm gonna give your grown ass a wedgie.
Handful of ass.
I'm not gonna hold you. That is the funniest shit I've heard today. That's...
Boy, you're freaky.
No, I'm just saying you ain't never thought about it like that, did you? Because what if you missed the draws? It's just ass in your hand. Then what? You feel
good? Why are you going that deep? You was a freaky ass dude, bro. Stop.
Fuck around, give a nigga a wedgie. He ain't got no draws that day. Touch his balls.
Oh, my God.
Why would you grab it from the front?
Hey, you too freaky, bro.
From the back. Grab the balls from the back.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Chill out.
No, a handful of ass is crazy.
Bro.
Hey.
It's crazy.
It's crazy
because he ain't never thought about that.
I'm not trying to.
That's what I'm saying. Don't be going out here giving niggas wedgies at the end of the day. You give a nigga a wedgie, you might get a handful of ass.
Keep that thought in your mind.
Bro, you know what? You got it, bro. I don't even want nothing to do with you.
Give a nigga a noogie like
bro.
You said,
cool.
Not a wedgie.
Damn, why the comments just start tweaking like that?
Cause nigga said a handful of ass. Nigga, she started talking about that shit.
Oh, God.
You niggas need to be arrested. What the fuck is wrong with you?
He needs to be arrested.
Nah, she need to get arrested. Cause
you don't want why I'm trying to get grown men wedgies?
Okay, I'm gonna get y'all this up there. How would y'all feel if mama said, fuck y'all?
Fuck her.
No, just
no dead ass.
No, like dead ass. Like y'all, say I had fallen out with her, whatever. Like
I feel like with my mama for a couple years.
Issues between, I mean, not real issues, but you feel some kind of way about like how she treated you coming up.
I did.
Some type of like.
I feel like with my mom for a couple years. Me and my mom did become back cool until I was like 20. I take it back like 19 because it was back when I started college because I fucked up to say I needed help with FAFSA. But like me and my mama didn't have a good relationship. Like it
how
was
you rekindle that kind of relationship with
you? It wasn't a rekindle. It was more so me letting go of hurt because I had to realize like my mama lost her mama at a young age. So like a lot of the shit that she would have learned as a woman from her mother, she didn't get to learn. So she having me not knowing what to do, just like being young and shit.
Me.
I mean, you can make excuses for whatever you want to make excuses for, but at the end of the day, like, shit, you can hold on to that hurt or you can let it go. And I realize holding on to that hurt won't get me nowhere.
Was she young when she had me?
I fucked with that. Yeah.
How young was she when she
my
had
me? My mom was 17 when she had my brother. She was 20 when she had me, but she was 17 when she lost her mama. So, like, I think my mama my brother met my grandma like once or twice before she passed type shit, but like my mama lost her mom at a young age, so like I, as a kid, I never understood it. Like as a kid, I used to damn near have hate in my heart towards my mama, because I used to be like, you know, when in hell you treating us like this, like it's this, that, and the third going on, and you worry about this, that, and the third, like you got fucking kids. But I also grew to understand, like becoming an adult, like some issues, like some shit you just can't foresee. Like you, it just life happens out how it happens, and in another sense, she never fully grew up. She had to grow up without a mom. She didn't have her dad in her life. She had to become her own person young. She had to become her own person young. So with that being said, like once I realized that, it was easier for me to let that hurt go, because I, you know, I lived with my grandparents throughout high school, all throughout high school. Like my upbringing in Kansas City was from Myron and LaWanda Taylor. Like it wasn't from my mother nor my father. So like, and I had to let that hurt go with my dad, because my dad was out of my life. He was in jail for 11 years, and I had to understand that his stupid decisions is the reason why he wasn't in my life. And he had to understand that too, as a grown man coming out. When you went in, I was 6. You came out, I'm 17. You can't parent me like you did when I was 6. Mm. Now that I'm 17, like I'm on other, like life is different. So it was more so at the end of the day, getting over hurt that shit, I realized I can't change. Like at the end of the day, this shit happened, and that shit that happened made me who I am. So shit, I salute him to this day. Like, yeah, y'all did what y'all did, but y'all, when it came to where y'all at now as grandparents, and as individuals of this world, is way better.
She might
tear a little bit. No, I ain't gonna tear. But I like, you gotta know, like what I've realized lately, because life just been life like a motherfucker. Like you lose motherfucker, you'll see a motherfucker one day, and then you'll lose him the next day. So like, it's so easy to be mad at somebody for stupid shit. It is way easy to be mad at somebody for some stupid, versus having that conversation with that person, because you never know, that might be that last time you have a conversation with that person. Mm-hmm. Shorty that just got killed, literally just seen her on what's her name, at the Power and Light. Mm-hmm. Gave her a hug. Her mom and my mom was like this, like grew up as kids, like type shit. So I told her, be safe. I literally, be safe. Gave her a hug, all this, and then to see that, like you will never know when it's the last time you'll see somebody. So. Little petty shit, like little petty arguments, little petty ass, oh, I'm mad at you about this, that, and the third. That shit is over with. Leave that shit alone. Motherfuckers is dying left and right, and there's nothing that you can do to stop it.
And that's why you gotta normalize telling your people that you love them.
Facts.
Nothing gay.
Hey, bro, don't look at me with that sad shit, bro.
No, real
I've been
shit,
doing
you
this shit.
I'm looking at you.
No, real shit, though. Real
I ain't trying to hear none of that shit.
I done told you
love plenty of times.
I got a real issue with that shit.
No, I be telling him love.
Yeah. And I've been doing it, so I don't want to hear all that shit from you niggas. The fuck?
No. I'm pressing about that last week.
I do, too.
When I talked to you the other day,
me too, Nia.
All right,
bro, love.
You hung up, and I... Nah, nah.
Oh, my mama,
you hung up. And I said it right after you hung up. Oh, God.
Love, bro. He's like, all right, bro.
And I said love, and you hung up, bro. Oh, God.
I greeted Milo. What's up, beloved?
What's up?
After I hang up with bro, love, bro.
Oh, God.
When I tell to see this nigga, it was good seeing you, bro. Love you, bro. You feel me? Real shit. You got
this nigga here?
This nigga had to say love. Hey, he too boozy. That's what I'm talking about. I told him he got one more time.
Looking ass. Because in our group chat, he'll admit that he like misses us from time to time.
I just don't care. I don't tell niggas I love them 24/7, bro.
I'm talking about this shit.
Y'all getting annoyed with this shit now.
When I profess my love, nigga, you better profess your love back.
I swear.
The fuck we talking about, nigga?
You're talking about.
You're supposed to be brothers.
What? Oh, God.
Oh, God.
I love you, nigga.
Nigga.
Love me.
The fuck are you talking about? I told you love you and say shit. Nigga, I'm about to smash your ass
behind that shit. Fuck is you, nigga? If I say I love you,
y'all,
I love you,
bro. Y'all need some hugs.
Y'all need some hugs, bro.
Nah, I'm swear shit. Same shit you said to me, my brother Jamal. We was at odds. He pulled up on me. The last time I seen him, he pulled up on me like, nigga, fuck all that weird nigga shit, nigga. It's us. Woo, nigga. He went and did what he did and died that night. I swear to God. Nigga, once we was like, all right, man, that's some lame-ass nigga shit. Mm-hmm. We was at odds over some petty shit. It was real petty, but we both tourists, so we bullheaded.
Yeah, bullheaded, yeah.
We bullheaded.
Yeah, and nobody so gonna like, ever see
me. So
wrong.
When he pulled up on me, nigga, he pulled up on me, see me and my grandma. I'm like, fuck all that weird-ass shit, woo-woo. Nigga, I ain't see my brother again after that. Nigga, you need to normalize telling your people you love them.
You got you.
Nigga, I brought that shit in my circle.
So if you watching this shit right now, you got somebody, you got a friend out there, man. Tell him you love him, man. Tell all your friends you love him right now.
I love y'all, man.
I love you, nigga.
I love you, guys.
Fat niggas. You hear me?
Fuck all y'all. I love all my people. You hear me? I
love my guys.
Don't expect to get that shit out of me like that, bro. I'm just not that nigga, bro. I'm sorry.
Bro, shut up.
It'll never be that, bro.
Take your little
Instagram ass.
While we were talking,
you're not gonna say that, son? You're not gonna say it back. We love you too, nigga. Like, we.
Okay. Yeah, oh, God. God. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Bro, y'all need to
be. Beat your ass, nigga.
Nobody ever introduced
me.
And you, black ass nigga, don't think I didn't say it, nigga.
Nobody. Bro, it was too many people talking. I love all y'all niggas, bro. Sincerely, bro.
Yeah, I'll put nigga on the shirt behind you niggas. I probably wouldn't. I'll put him in jail, though. I'm telling.
I'll put him in jail, though.
I told you, I'll put a nigga name in Old English over you niggas.
Love you too, nigga.
Yeah, we love you. Yeah, Dad, we love your old ass. You and Miss Judy.
Bro,
I'm not. We don't have this moment like that. This nigga is small.
I'm not about. I just said the same.
Look how mad it got.
You want to be anti-social?
I'm not about to keep doing it.
Mike, keep getting mad.
Every time one of y'all motherfuckers said, I just said I love y'all. Y'all want me to keep on? Y'all want me to go around the world? Tell y'all love y'all. No.
All this love shit is pissing Mike off. Y'all shut the fuck up with the love.
I do.
He's the most.
We don't have this moment.
Worry about, bro.
He's the most Sagittarius man I've ever met in my life.
I'm like, damn.
You sound like Badge.
Niggas do say a lot.
Niggas say, like, no, I ain't gonna hold you. One love is dusty. That's crusty to the motherfucker. Niggas say one love.
My uncle be saying that shit to me.
Yuck,
man. Somebody tell me
what's saying. Don't be saying love.
One sound. I think of fucking.
Somebody said, get that nigga a hug. Yo, you sport.
Drumline, hell yeah.
One sound.
One love, one band, one sound. Fuck shit.
I'm not gonna hold you. I've been laughing at this shit all week. That nigga Sean, bro, is the funniest nigga on God's earth. You wanna know why? We went to Trinae's house because it was dark in the motherfucker in their goddamn hallway.
Oh my God.
This nigga said this one of them Marcus Houston gets stomped down hallway. What was the song them niggas
If heaven
good?
Was a mile away?
Yeah. If heaven was a mile away? I'm fucking lost it.
They fixed that light, by the way, so don't. It ain't Rob
City.
We
know. It ain't been sketchy for a minute.
Hey, I used to have to go in that bitch with my flashlight on just to get my key in the keyhole.
Fuck the flashlight, nigga.
Is that how it is with niggas? Never mind.
Nah.
Wait, niggas, what?
Coochie. I feel like that was going to take a dramatic turn.
I was going to say, is that what it's like putting a penis in the hole?
I knew.
It was the first time.
What?
Yeah.
Like, first time
like when you was a virgin?
I'm not
couldn't
baby.
Figure out how to, I can't, like.
She had to do it for her to put it in.
Yeah, hey, I was fucking a scrape.
Yeah, she was scrape as fuck. Oh, God.
Well, no, she wasn't.
I figured it out, bro. I had to go through the.
That nigga used to hump his couch. I know it.
Ain't nobody
spot.
Do that to no couch, no.
I'm not gonna hold you. Like,
you said,
I ain't gonna work.
Come on,
like,
he said, what?
You used to hit the bed?
The hole, like, a little bit under, you know what I mean? Like, I was at the middle, right here on that shit. Like, I didn't know where the fuck meat was supposed to go in coochie hole. I'm not gonna hold you.
Meat yeah, I ain't know. I ain't know.
I had no idea. I was
thinking I was fucking when I was.
Did y'all?
Straight butt cheeks.
I thought I was fucking.
They straight butt cheeks. She let you
know
she wasn't trying to fuck.
Yeah,
she would be
if she let
time,
you, she wasn't trying to fuck.
Kids, though, but
it ain't no being a kid.
I was between straight butts.
If you was between butt cheeks, she wouldn't let you fuck.
I was dry humping early, bro.
At what age was y'all dry humping?
Oh, God.
Oh, shit.
Dry humping.
Elementary.
Boy,
elementary.
That's y'all niggas from.
Second
y'all
grade,
were hypersexual.
Like
y'all
second
hypersexual
grade?
As fuck.
Second
grade?
Oh,
God.
Damn.
Now,
motherfuckers do be hypersexual because
you're
that's true.
I ain't gonna lie. If you went to Satchel Paige, you know it was some
if
freaky
you
shit
are
going
around. If you are around sex at a young age, you tend to be very hypersexual.
Accidentally hypersexual.
I got freaky maybe around like third, fourth grade just because I seen belly. I seen how DMX fucked that bitch Keisha. I'm going to tag me in back like that one day. Oh, my mama.
I ain't going to lie, bro.
They don't know about such a babe.
Hey, I got suspended for writing my girlfriend a sex letter, boy.
What? Oh, you was being freaky.
Hey, I was about what? I was about fourth, fifth grade, boy.
What you say to
her?
I need to hear what you say.
I don't remember, bro.
You remember, nigga. Don't do
it. No, I remember the girl, but I don't remember.
Nah. What you write, bro?
You know what you said to that girl.
For that letter, he remembered it verbatim.
That nigga's like 50 Cent off Get Rich or Die Trying. First we get the touching, then we get the loving.
I can't like the French you put my tongue in your ear.
We're
gonna let our genius on the show break that down for you.
Hypersexual? Okay, so being hypersexual is just like you are overly like sexual, like sexual, like everything about your day is about sex. Like you can't go without thinking about sex type shit. It's damn near like a nympho, but a nympho
a lot of females.
Actual, like a nympho, no, will a nympho act on those sexual acts. That's what make you a nympho. You can be hypersexual just by always thinking about sex.
Always talking about it. Yeah.
Talk about sex.
Always like joking about
you
it.
You out here fucking everything like that's moving. You might be a nympho. Like you literally have a sex addiction.
And a lot of you know. But if you're a nympho, you're hypersexual as well.
Yeah.
But
I
you
mean,
can. But you can be hypersexual without being a nympho.
I can attest to myself probably being that.
A nympho? Or
hypersexual?
As a young kid. That's normally what it is. You experience something at a young age that you were not supposed to experience, whether it was your babysitter as a male, because that's a lot of things that I found out like now that men are more so opening up about certain shit. A lot of men were fucked by older, like their older babysitters, or they had sexual experience with their.
It's a lot of female women. Predators out there. Yeah, don't ever get it twisted. Don't ever get it twisted.
The reason why it's not as known is because men were not. Y'all not susceptible. Y'all not taught to talk about shit like that.
No,
we not taught to think that shit's wrong.
That's what it is.
Because like when you think you getting pussy from an older lady,
you think it's a good thing. You think you on the open up. Oh
yeah.
God.
Yeah.
But that's like that can bring out hypersexual activity.
Sure. I ain't gonna lie to you. I wouldn't change it for the world.
Oh my God.
If an older woman
getting pushed up on by an older bitch when I was younger,
you going to jail?
Because it definitely happened to me.
Going to jail. The fastest jail I could put her in.
If a bitch wouldn't make it up. Son or
touch
my brother.
Son if you want to.
I have a little brother that's 4. You're if I was to find out a fucking 14-year-old out here trying to suck on him, what, bitch, you're going to, you, I'm going to fuck you up.
That's nasty.
But
that's
how the fuck do you as a woman? No. That's then. Back like, then, this is something that was going
older,
on.
When motherfuckers got older siblings and older relatives and they talk about sex, like, not even to us, but we hear about, like, boy.
That'll make you, I get it. That can make you hypersexual.
Talk around kids, motherfuckers talk
and that'll,
kids.
And that'll do it, too.
And people that can make you hypersexual. Porn.
No, motherfuckers talk around kids thinking they not understanding what's going on, but... Mm-hmm. Nigga, I used to hear my brother talk about some boy out.
Bending this bitch down.
Leaving the little porn CDs around and stuff.
I ain't hold. Y'all see my first
Yes,
porn,
a virgin can be hypersexual.
Fuck yeah.
You don't necessarily have to be sexual to be hypersexual. Mm-hmm. A virgin can, they can spend all of their free time watching fucking porn. Mm-hmm. They ain't fucking and sucking and doing anything.
So,
that's very hypersexual.
I ain't gonna say no names, but just think back to a lot of the girls that we went to school with, bro. That were hypersexual virgins, bro.
Real talk, though.
And a lot of them wasn't virgins.
You hear me? That part.
What he say?
He said what?
Perry.
Her ass was one
Perry.
Of them.
Perry.
Oh, God.
She was one of them.
I had class.
Oh, God.
Hey, yeah.
That you was one of them.
That used to go crazy.
Like Perry. Like Perry.
You know I know
Perry was. Bro.
Hey,
but Perry, but Perry was actually
with a lot of rabbits, bro.
Perry's still a virgin.
Perry's still a virgin. She's very hypersexual for a virgin.
Motherfuckers like Perry, then the preacher's daughter, bro. They be hypersexual.
Oh, the preacher's daughter ain't hypersexual. They
fuck. Nah, they getting bust down.
They
fuck.
I'm saying they be hypersexual because, like, when you, this is a forbidden fruit. I'm gonna go bite that motherfucker.
Oh, God.
And the preacher's daughter is actually getting skint. Like, what? Perry wasn't actually
getting
skint. No,
Sterling, it's not the same as liking to be pleased. Like, sex is sex, and, like, yeah, you can like pleasure and all that. That's different. But hypersexuality is like everything that you do revolves around sex.
Like on some Quagmire shit.
On some, yeah.
Oh, yeah, Quagmire
shit. Like, you gotta get
giddy. He was a nympho, but
he was a nympho.
You gotta be.
He's a nympho, but
he was hypersexual.
With a nympho, if you're a nympho, you're hypersexual, but you can be hypersexual without being an info.
She's not lying.
Hypersexual, basically.
All nymphos are hypersexual, but not all hypersexual people are nymphos.
And think about Quagmire. What if he actually wasn't actually like skinning all of those females, but he was just still making all those jokes and all
he
that
still
shit?
Would be,
he would still be hypersexual.
That's hypersexual.
So.
That's a hoe.
The nympho
no,
makes it.
Y'all yeah, remember when Peter
gripping all of them? Yeah, really gripping all of them.
A nympho is they just can't control their like you have people that like to have sex that doesn't make you just because you like sex right. Nympho. A nympho they cannot
like that's your vice. Like that's your go to. Like,
yeah, like how we smoke. Like how,
how we
blunt,
smoke. Yeah,
they gotta suck some dick. That's a
yeah,
nympho.
Yeah, that's a nympho. On God,
like, I wake up in the morning. Damn, what dick can I have? Like that's
I love that type of bitch. On God,
you say you love that type of bitch, but when you can't please that bitch every time and she gotta go find another.
Go ahead!
And you're not gonna never be able to please her.
I ain't gonna lie.
There is no pleasing.
If
no matter what you do,
she gonna have to have something in
somebody
else.
I'm not gonna lie, because when you break it down like that, that's a case and I'm a nympho. Because I done definitely had a woman.
You're not a nympho. You're just hypersexual.
Nah, bro. You're not a nympho.
You're not a nympho. Shot, you're not a nympho.
Let him explain.
Nigga, you dead ass can't. Like, you fiending for the shit. Like, you a dope fiend.
I am fiending for it.
No, bro.
So, Do nymphos
fiend
for a nut, or do they just
fiend? The best way to have you...
Sex.
They fiend for sexual contact. They don't even care who it's from.
Go on Netflix. It's a movie called Nymphomaniac.
Look, you're trying to be thirsty. You want to be a nympho so bad.
Nah.
Listen, it's a movie on Netflix called Nymphomaniac. It'll explain to you in theory and like verbatim how a nympho thinks. Like the opening scene, this girl is fucking 16 years old. She goes into a train station. It's a nigga there. I want dick. Guess what she does? Fuck this man. Don't know him from a can of paint. Don't know if he got anything. Like, she wanted that. Like, that's the type of shit that'll make you a nympho. Like, you have some type of standard to what you do. A nympho don't give a fuck.
They don't care who it's from.
It is a compulsive sexual behavior which is characterized by excessive sexual fantasies, urges, and behaviors, as well as the impulse to act on them with consenting individuals.
The impulse to act on them.
You don't have no control to, like, I can't not fuck you right now. Like, nympho would sit next to you and be like,
"Ooh, this dick hard.
I'm about to get that dick right now." Without, like nothing you done said or did or just, but she want that. That's the type of shit that they be on.
Okay, no, I'm just hypersexual.
No.
Can a man be a nympho?
Huh?
Can a man be a nympho?
Yeah.
Niggas can be nymphos, but you will find more women. Which
that
is fucking
nympho,
crazy.
Yeah.
More women are going to be nymphos.
I feel like women are more hypersexual than men.
It's easier for a woman to be a nympho than it is for a man. Just end of the day.
That is fact.
No, it ain't even about the shit we go through.
It's easier to get it.
You go around trying to get that dick out, you'll look like a pervert. 25-8. At the end of the day, you go around trying to do fuck, suck, all that. You go to a train, say, "Hey, bitch, I want your coochie." You're going to be a pervert.
You're going to jail fast.
Facts.
Quick.
Facts.
Ain't no way around it. That's the double standard behind it. But a bitch do it, right, nigga?
That's not necessarily fast because it is some cringy, creepy females out there.
It is.
Facts.
But majority of the niggas, if it's the right nigga, they not going to give a fuck. Coochie is coochie. But when it comes to bitches.
No, coochie is not coochie.
She said the right nigga. She didn't say every nigga. She said the right nigga.
Exactly. I hate that term.
Come ask your question.
Right? Coochie is crazy.
Coochie is
I'm
coochie.
I'm gonna try, so I can ask this question.
I'm just asking.
You can't too.
No, I was agreeing with her when she said that shit crazy.
Check it out though. It's your boy Jonte Casanova, aka Mind of a Misfit.
Damn, nigga.
Yep. Is you cool, bro?
I was scared of this man.
Is you cool, bro?
Is you cool? I'm good, bro.
Is you cool, bro?
Shot, bro. Shot, bro. It's me, bro. Listen.
It's me, bro.
Anyways, bro, listen.
Oh, can't keep me dirty.
He did come over.
Hey,
what's up? It's your boy.
Hey, it's your boy Dontego Casanova, aka Mr. Lay That Goodwood, aka Mind of a Misfit. If you tapped into my shit last week, we had some shit going on, and the question was, you hearing me? If you could hook up with any host from any other podcast, who would it be? Perry gave her list out. Craig gave his list out. Skinny gave her list out. Terry gave his list out. My baby brother. He gave his list out. I gave my list out. Perry gave her list out. It's a lot of people. Peel gave his list out. It was Milani, but that's biased. Anyways.
That's biased.
Anyways.
Babe.
We just pod. God damn it.
We just podding.
So I want to know. We got.
Who want to go
one,
first?
2, 3, 4, 5
right,
hoes.
I'm going first.
Remember that what you said in the group chat? Remember, nigga?
Don't get mad at me.
Y'all can tag Barnes in this one.
Nah, nigga, what you say? You gonna tag me, nigga?
What?
RPC.
You want me to tag her?
Still here?
Look, Rashida, come here. That's all I wanted to say. Y'all can go and do y'all list now. Go ahead, my mama. Brother.
Shit, I ain't got no list. I ain't got no list.
You wanna bust down nobody.
Scary Mary.
I can't.
No, you can't. It's a disclaimer. It's not. People in the podcast world don't fuck. This just that's if you could. You feel me?
I can't think of nobody right now off the top of my head.
Cap.
No, that's facts. I can't think of nobody off the top of my head.
Go ahead. Go ahead, bro.
Basically, it's your turn.
No, how the fuck you skip
from me? Go ahead, Angela, bro.
Damn.
Because he done.
Dirty motherfucker, shut up.
Go ahead.
Shit.
Misfit hit list. Go ahead.
Shit. Right, Tati. Scary Mary.
Skinny probably, you know what I mean? Come join the party. I ain't gonna hold you.
Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that.
Shit. That's about it.
Who did you say?
You only gonna stop with skinny?
Skinny probably.
Who is skinny?
Yeah.
Who is that?
Adriana.
You gonna always, Ivy probably could join the party, maybe. Ivy.
Yeah.
She could join the party. She could join the party, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Wait, who was the other one?
You said
skinny, Ivy, and Sheeta.
They could join the party on God.
They skinny.
Look. I'll be 1,006%. Yeah, be Simone.
Nah, for BLE, nigga.
Wow, shit.
Yeah, that's the caveat too.
Hey,
sell it,
boy.
My options kind of slim, you know. So it's a lot of niggas at BLE.
It's not though.
That one bitch you brought here last week, she could join the party.
Are we talking about guests too?
Call no bitch.
I'm sorry, not the call.
Are we talking about guests?
That lovely young woman, my boo.
We just talking about host
people on the podcast.
Because we talking about guests, my list is just
red pill, red pill, red pill is inconclusive.
What? I can't say that.
Red pill, red pill, red pill is inconclusive. But anyway, we're gonna get back to you. Go ahead.
I don't like.
Key. Oh yeah.
I don't see myself fucking no other co-host.
You wouldn't hook up.
She on the list.
Nobody.
She on the list.
No, not on Kansas City podcast. Not that I like.
Well, any podcast. Shoot like, shit. We did it to show love to the city though.
Like I get that, but like I don't like podcasts in general. I don't.
My list was crazy.
I'm trying to think like.
That's what I'm saying. I can't think of nobody.
Like I don't think of nobody. Like only people like are like guests and shit like. Rashida them, like, I don't see them in that type of fashion. Like, I don't see myself cracking none of that.
Boo, tomatoes.
Tomatoes.
Moving along.
I don't know none of these people.
Bro. That's exactly what the problem is. I guess it would be.
Bro, I don't either.
No, I ain't got no fucking body, no, honestly.
But I don't know none of these people, bro.
List, gang.
Who?
Go ahead. God,
you are on some list. You are on some list.
Who else?
You want to take a list? Go ahead.
Stug got good pussy.
I hate it.
If you know, you know.
They got that.
Bonnie?
Crickets.
Who said my list is just
Red pill,
there you go.
Man. And Skinny.
Who is these people, bro?
Dartego Cast, no freaky, Mind bro. Of Misfit Podcast.
Who your nah nigga? Give your list out.
I gave my list out. Y'all gotta go watch.
Hey, bro, you see what
you did
bro,
it on your show today? Oh,
yes, bro.
Freaky Reynolds is crazy.
And I did all my shit by the twos.
I said my list just got bigger. I ain't say it's just as big. My list, if we talking about
who
guests,
now,
that's
whole
yeah, my no, shit.
We're doing guests, boy.
Oh, yeah, we got some guests. I got a list for your
some
ass.
Some guests that can come join the party.
You
got the
guests you already fucked.
I'm not talking.
I just got.
What you want?
I just got one, and she didn't even come to our show. Oh, God.
You tripping.
You
what?
Just played your hand, bro. I'm just capping.
Yeah, we talking about
no,
guests and shit.
Oh, it ain't no...
Top guest?
Who y'all got
on your list?
I got a list of guests.
Shit.
Who y'all
got on your list for the guests?
All right.
Who y'all got?
Shit,
bitch, I'm gonna say name.
What's that on my beat?
Oh, I got one y'all ain't even thinking about.
Been here or been a part of the network.
I got one y'all ain't even thinking about right now.
That on my BD shorty?
Motherlicious.
Yeah.
She smooth.
Y'all already know Slim would be
she
on my
smooth.
List.
Respect. She smooth.
And.
Charlie. Salute.
Bitch. Who the fuck? Don't play me.
Chill.
Trying to think. This nigga sick. He just sucked me up. I ain't gonna lie. Keyboard.
Definitely, yeah, Key for sure. Yeah.
I'm going yo.
I want.
Nah, I won't. I won't.
Key got
I like
too much
Key.
Booty for me. I ain't gonna lie.
Well, you crazy.
Key. You crazy. I like Key.
I like that's show. The one they had on the red.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Chico people.
Did y'all watch the end of that episode?
Yeah. Yeah. I ain't catch it. I ain't catch it.
Yeah.
Boy, it got
yeah,
spicy. Hey,
man, we're going to have to go ahead and wrap this up. We're not going to hold you, man, because we on here.
Hey, nah, the girl that did the waxes.
Oh, no. That bitch
Bishop. Bishop. Oh,
no, 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 no. Not that. That bitch got arrested. That bitch got arrested.
Yeah, she definitely got arrested.
But nah, that bitch you talking about that came through? Huh? She joined the party.
Yeah.
Who your list?
My list?
Oh, guess.
He said skinny, she
did. That's the guest list too, huh?
Nah, the guest list shit. Key. What's the other shorty name?
Yellow.
She can get it.
Yeah.
Honestly, that's a body
Key,
guy, I guess.
Key like my my sister. I ain't going Key.
She have good hugs.
Yeah,
she
I like Key. She cool people.
So from the
I don't be on that with her, but I like Key. You know what I'm saying?
But
like,
if you ever
I
fuck come with join Key. The
yeah,
party.
Yeah, yeah. I always just keep it cool, play it cool. But yeah, I do party, like Key though.
Fucking me and my bitch. That's what I mean. Like, you gotta fuck me and my bitch.
Oh my god.
No, I don't have parties. But
you got
I ain't got no girlfriend. I need that.
You ain't got no girl.
Nah, I'm in a relationship with these racks.
Yeah, facts.
Dumb racks too.
But yeah, I needs that.
Who your list?
Let me see that. I ain't got my glasses on.
The girl
hey,
from his pie
man.
Last
we back
week.
You niggas next week, man. To the
and the
man.
Waxing
big
girl.
Big heck loke, man. Tomorrow,
that nigga said
man,
big
ho.
Big
ho. Called you big hover. That's what he about to call you.
That nigga about to call you big hover.
Big snake, big
ho,
big.
Big snake, big
ho. Oh, oh wow, I was wrong.
Damn.
Oh wow.
D Lo Money, man.
Yo.
Body bags. Shot.
Yo, what's the word,
next week, man?
Man?
We out.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.